Blackstone Publishing presents A Going Concern by Catherine Aird. This book is read by Derek Perkins. The chapter headings comprise The Burial of the Linnet by Mrs. Ewing. 1. Found in the garden, dead in his beauty. The undertakers had been very helpful. No, she thought immediately to herself. That wasn't putting it anything like strongly enough. She promptly rephrased the sentiment in her mind. Messrs. J. Morton and Sons, funeral furnishers of Nethergate Street, Beerbury, couldn't, in the circumstances, the rather special circumstances, possibly have done more than they had done. Even that, she felt on consideration, wasn't quite stating the true position really fairly. Amelia, no dissembler, braced her shoulders and, for the very first time, she admitted the whole truth to herself, which was that without young Todd Morton's help, she wouldn't even have known where to begin to arrange this particular funeral. And here she was, only a week after Todd Morton had first spoken to her, following her great-aunt Octavia's coffin up the path towards the Church of St. Hilary, in the small village of Great Primer, in the county of Caleshire, after the manner born. It was after the manner born, too, as it happened. Great-aunt Octavia's cortege had set off only a very short time before from her home, the Grange at Great Primer, which was near enough to the church for the tardiest worshipper. A quick walker might even have waited for the minute bell before starting out. Amelia had followed in the first car behind the hearse, which was a clear sign to everyone else there of her position. The police had not been at all happy about this, earnestly counselling a rather lower profile. But in this respect, Amelia had been adamant. Chief mourner at the funeral she was, and in the place of chief mourner at the funeral she would be. And now Todd Morton, wearing a black suit with striped trousers, black gloves and top hat in hand, was standing discreetly at her elbow the while, and indicating to her what to do as if she had known him all her life, instead of only 7 days. The last 7 days. It had all begun with a death. Funerals usually did, thought Amelia grimly, following Todd Morton's unobtrusive directions with childlike obedience. As the coffin was carried through the lich gate, she found it quite difficult to believe that this time last week she'd been in the middle of a carefree holiday abroad. In fact, she had been vacationing in France when the strange message about her great-aunt Octavia's death had reached her. She and three of her friends had been renting a gîte for the month of August. They'd all shared school and then college, and a certain indefinable nostalgia had been keeping them together still for one last holiday before they were severally claimed by life and work. It had been Mary Louise who had actually picked up the telephone receiver when the instrument gave its unfamiliar Gallic trill. And she had been expecting nothing more earth-shattering than her mother ringing from home with her examination results. Until that moment, young Mary Louise hadn't thought that anything more earth-shattering existed than examination results. "It's for you, Millie." Mary Louise had looked quite distressed. "It's an undertaker, ringing from England." In the space of time that it had taken Amelia to cross the room to the telephone, she knew beyond doubt that it couldn't have been her father who had died. If it had been, then Phoebe, dear Phoebe, would have told her so herself, even if she had had to down tools and come out to Dordogne in person to do so. And yet, thought Amelia, very puzzled, it was only her stepmother Phoebe who had the telephone number of their holiday cottage near Montpazier. "Is that Miss Kennerley?" Todd Morton had asked. "Yes," said Amelia cautiously. "Dr. Plantin told me how to get in touch with you." Amelia had been even more reassured. Come hell or high water, Phoebe Plantin would never have delegated the breaking of really bad news to anyone else, but least of all to an unknown undertaker telephoning from another country. That, at least, confirmed her view that nothing terrible had happened to her father. "What about?" she had said then to Todd Morton. He could hardly be ringing about her own mother's grave. Nothing urgent happened to graves already 12 years old. She realized at once that her question must have...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.